vacation, Jenny. And besides, Mum thought my best friend would keep me out of trouble.
You sure it's all right for us to go inside?
Well, it belongs to our family. That's why we came all the way to Europe. Mum and Dad have to decide what to do with this museum. It belonged to my great-grandmother, and her mother's before her, and her mother's before her, and her mother's before her, and
I get the picture.
Okay. I brought the key to the back door so we don't have to break it.
Alex, do you read things?
Yes. Don't chicken out, Dad.
A very elegant and important ball. And at that ball, to be beautiful and talented to go to the ball of Cinderella.
Just Ella. My name is Ella.
You have to be refined to go to the ball like moi.
I have so much to do. Repel. Ella.
Cinderella.
I've reached my decision. You must stay here and clean the house. When Desiree, or Diana, is chosen as the prince's bride, the royal family will surely come to visit. It is your duty to ensure the house is spotless. You'd want your father to be proud of you, wouldn't you? Come along, my sweetheart, and we'll plan out the rest of this hairstyle.
Just flew in and came straight to you. Look at this place. Far out. Have a ball! And keep it real.
Two, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around 2 o'clock tonight. What is that?
Slippers.
authority.
And they gave directions.
Warning me not to reveal the location to anyone else.
I got lost a good number of times, but finally found the frog prince in the swamp valley. I came to the slipper.
A strange slipper.
A plastic. Let me explain.
I explained as best I could about the slipper. I never went to find my fairy godmother. She was still behind house. Fortunately, my stepmother Gertrude and stepsisters Desiree and Diane were sound asleep.
Slightly magic enhanced sleep.
My fairy godmother explained plastics and plastics. He was amazed.
Process. Now, would you like me to return you to your princely shape?
Well, thank you, madam. You're too kind. But no.
No!
No. I loved hot dancing with you. But I love my science even more. And as long as I'm a frog, I need not take my place on the throne. Indeed, no one will want me on the throne. For I would be mocked and unheeded. I prefer to devote my life to science.
I understand. I wish I could concentrate on my writing and not have to curb and clean and wait on my stepsisters. To have enough time and enough back paper. To work as I choose and then bring of my own.
I do, you. Aha! I see the solution.
Wood. Ink.
Laboratory.
The frog prince assured me he would wield his influence to free me from my horrible family.
Then suddenly, my stepmother who heard our voices during this, she did not see my godmother, but magically turned herself invisible. Gertrude was shocked that the frog prince would choose me over one of her daughters. I did not feel it necessary to inform her of the part that my fairy godmother had played.
I cannot believe it! Your Highness! She's little more than a kitchen wench. She's not worthy of someone so distinguished, so unique. I mean, a person of your lineage and power. Not the frog part. I mean,
only
I don't know what I mean.
Madam, I truly recommend you stop trying to mean anything. You need not pack this lovely and talented woman's belongings. I'll provide all her heart's desires.
There's one thing I must take with me.
Mother! No, never!
Ready?
Cinder!
Ella, my name is Ella.
Come, girls, let's maintain what dignity we still possess.
Time is fun when your happy flies.